My name is Asia Robinson, and I am a senior here at Lincoln College Prep. I am excited to show you a project that Lincoln students have been working on throughout Black History Month. The project is called Blacknificent, and celebrates the rich history and legacy of Lincoln. This project comes from Lincoln's partnership with the Black Community Fund. They're partnering with us on Blacknificent, a scholarship that is aimed at making college more affordable for Black LCPA scholars. Every dollar you donate is matched by the BFC and given right back to seniors at Lincoln. That's right. Every single dollar you donate stays right here in Lincoln. And when you help us reach our goal of $10,000, we'll be able to award two $5,000 scholarships and 10 $1,000 scholarships this spring at graduation. Here are alumni Jalila Otto, Chanel Smith, and Darren Story to talk about what Black deficiency means to them and how important these scholarships are.
I like that word, Blacknificence. I haven't heard that one before. You know, sometimes in this life, you are just enough just how you are. In the skin that you were born, with the background that you have, with the opportunity that you get. Sometimes you are just enough. That's probably Blacknificence.
To that, anytime we competed in anything, academically or athletically, we did so in a way that other schools thought we were arrogant. But we really just knew our worth, we knew our value, we knew wherever we were, we belonged. And that is Blacknificence, just not questioning the fact that we're awesome. And I learned that at Lincoln.
Yes, absolutely, yeah. I got lots of, if I didn't get scholarships, I would not have went to college.
Right.
Yeah. I mean, it would have meant the world to me then. If you gave me $5,000 right now, it would mean the world to me now. I would be grateful for $5,000 whenever you gave it to me. Tuition is also, a factor is figuring out how to pay for this. The cost of college now is, it's doubled since I was in school, if not tripled in some circumstances. So $5,000 means it means a lot. It really does.
But in those days, $5,000, that would have been rich, you know. It would have been a great honor, and I think it would be a great honor even today.
But we have to be able to level the playing field by coming up with these types of scholarships because, let's face it, the playing field is not level. It is terribly important now that kids have the opportunity to partake in these scholarships, and any amount of money, anything, gets them closer to that goal.
They're right. I hope you can help us level the playing field and make college more affordable for the class of 2021 seniors. Alrighty, let's get this ball rolling. Our project, Blacknificent, is made up of two parts. First, we'll talk with the alumni about their experience at LCPA and what LCPA means to them. After we hear from Chanel Smith, Ronald Walton, Jalila Otto, Alan Wayne, and Darren Story about their LCPA days, we'll see several current students showcase their talents. Thank you for being a part of something bigger, for sharing your time and money with us, for making college more affordable, and more importantly, for caring about the success of students at Lincoln College Preparatory Academy. And from here, let the show begin.
My name is Chanel Smith. I am a Lincoln Prep graduate, class of 1999. I am a Lincoln legacy. Both my parents went to Lincoln. I actually met my now husband here at Lincoln, so we are high school sweethearts. And our oldest son is now a student at Lincoln Middle. I am currently the associate principal of the African-Centered Upper School at Southeast High School and the founder of HBCU Walking Billboard. HBCU Walking Billboard is a nonprofit organization that promotes awareness of, attendance to, and graduation from historically Black colleges and universities. I just want to say that my ability to establish this organization was also birthed here at Lincoln. So HBCU Walking Billboard wouldn't exist if it wasn't for Lincoln Prep. Say that this place is a place of homage, is kind of a symbolism of my ancestry, where I've come from, and my legacy and lineage, like where I'm headed in terms of my own children coming here. But on a silly note, I guess, it's really the place that I've had the time of my life. High school was the best experience for me. And I think that what I am grateful for from Lincoln, though, is that college felt a lot less difficult because of the rigor that I experienced at this building. I would encourage Black students at Lincoln to stand firm in the footsteps that have been put before you. really amazing individuals have come through this school, and it is on their shoulders that you stand. So every day that you come into this building, you are carrying out the dreams and the vision of people who really sacrificed a lot to get you to this beautiful space that you all have right now. With that, I would say, once you graduate from Lincoln, your work is not done. The only way Lincoln continues to have the legacy and the heritage that we all know it to have is if we continue to give back to it, send our children to it, and ensure that it stands for a long time.
My name is Ronald Walton. I graduated in 1954. And in 1987, they gave a big picnic. And that was the planning platform for the formation of the National Alumni. And it was legally formed in 1988, and I've been a member ever since. I've served in several different positions. Presently, I'm serving as president of the National Association, which is a job that I enjoy immensely. To me, it is the most significant and historical Black school. That's what it means to me. And to be part of that legacy, it's really difficult to put into words, because being a member of the alumni, not just as president, we have tried very hard to explain to students what the significance of this building is. This is not just a school you come to for 4 years and go off to college. You should understand that this has a legacy. So look into that legacy while you're here. So as you travel on in life to whatever endeavors you intend, you will understand where your education, at least semi-secondary, started at Lincoln College Prep. In your group that you ran around with, talking about school, it was kind of considered uppity. But you wanted to be uppity. You wanted to come to this beautiful building. But when I walked through the doors here, it was mind-blowing. It was so beautiful. So beautiful. Oh, I could sit here and talk forever about the education that I got and the teachers that I had. Because I know for a fact that Lincoln is the best place to start on the path to secondary education, which hopefully will lead you to your life's vocation. And I think the kids here should embrace the opportunity if they only knew whose shoulders they were on. I think they would appreciate their time here. I'll never, ever forget this school, and I will always work to better the school and do what I can.
Sure, my name is Jalila Otto, and I graduated from Lincoln College Prep in 1995. But I remember my father actually brought my sister and I up to the building maybe a week or two before school started, because he was a Lincoln alumni, and he showed us the hallways, and it took a little bit of the intimidation out of it, but it shaped him into the man that he became, and I know it shaped me into the woman that I became. I think Lincoln did a really good job teaching me how to be autonomous and create goals for myself, and to work toward those goals, no matter what the obstacles that may come up, because there's always going to be obstacles. That's the one thing that's never going to go away. But how do you pursue those dreams and goals when it gets really hard? And Lincoln really taught me tenacity and endurance. So I'm very proud of my daughter and how Lincoln has helped produce her into the person that she is. Things are not going to be handed to her, in this life as they weren't to me. And she's going to have to really begin to learn how to advocate for herself, which you have to do in a public school setting. And you really have to become responsible for your actions. And so I think those are timeless lessons. And I'm excited that she learned them in this building. The Castle on the Hill. That's what we called it. That's what my dad called it. I hope that's what kids call it. It's a castle on a hill. And when you think about all of the metaphors that go along with castle, you're royalty. I mean, you are royalty. You are the best that this city has to offer. Don't ever, ever, ever hold your head down or feel like you're not worthy or you're not worth it. You came from a castle. Everybody can't say that. They can't say that. And that's what Lincoln means to me.
All right, my name is Alan Wayne. I'm sorry if I've been looking off camera this whole time or the young lady interviewing me. I'm just really happy to be here. But class of 2001, everything started on this stage here. You know, by the time I left 2001, by the time the new seniors were coming back, they had my new album.
Resuscitate, please sign. Almost died for you two or three times. Could have been done, hit me with the peace sign. Instead, got in them, hit me with the rewind button. Got in them, hit the rewind button. Now my third eye's open, I can see y'all coming. When I see demons coming, I take a beeline from them. I don't need no clutch, ain't gotta lean on nothing. When somebody would have told me that in high school. St. Osbrew's in the Kool-Aid picture, we was high too. A little girl wouldn't have been able to concentrate if I would have tried to. But I went to school to skip school. After the principal lied and told my mama I was selling dope, you'd skip you. My pops even had the nerve to try to say something, probably loaded right now. But I'ma forget you. Issues. Galore though, blowing nerves, I'ma need more of those. Drinking the drug on like I knew it was immortal. Till I took a trip to the other side of that portal. I'm thinking this is it, Lord. The big one, the bullets are flying. I'm pretty sure I just bit one. But that's alright with me, I'm tired of living like a victim. Heaven or hell, I don't give a fuck, just pick one. Sickness in my system, I can't get it out of me. I don't know the difference between my nightmares and reality. Get something with the heaven, I know that would be a tragedy. My mother and my sister and woman would all be mad at me. But I don't wanna face it, I can't take it.
Alright, that's a good question. I actually, Alan Wayne, that's actually my government. Alan Wayne Williams, so that's my name. But Prodigy, that came from a teacher here, one of my language arts teachers, Miss Skaggs. I used to write poems when I wasn't supposed to be writing poems, and she used to make me read them, and she said that she gave me that name. So a lot of my everything came from these hallways, for real. This is like everything, like my best of times, my worst of times. Like there's some pretty deep, for lack of a better term, dark imagery in the song I just played, but it was real, it was here. And some of the other music is, you know, as happy as I wanna be, and it's hard to not say that a lot of that's drawn from here. I mean, my biggest accolade to this day maybe is on the Tech N9ne album that I believe is certified gold now. And even on that album, on the song It Was an Accident, I tell a loosely based story talking about Lincoln. I say, so I'm leaving Lincoln High School off Woodland, headed to the hood to hang out with the hoodlums. I mean, that was my introductory to Billboard, and I was talking about this school. This is the most nervous I've ever been on stage is right now. You know, I'm not nervous, but still, like in comparison, this is something to me. This means a lot. But well, it's gotta be, they always say it's the best of times and the worst of times. It was that day after that, when Miss James made me perform on this stage, you know, I thought I was Jay-Z after that. I had tickets to a Jay-Z concert. My mama said, don't leave school. You know, don't leave school. But I know, mama, but I'm Jay-Z now. You know, I just tore up the school. They talk about me. So when I came back my senior year, you know, it was a whole different appreciation. You know, I really cherished those years. That senior year, Lincoln was probably one of the most precious years of my life still. The moment that I wanted to relive is being relived right now. So I want to make it back on this stage in some form that has something to do with music again, and here we are. And I couldn't have planned or plotted this out my own way any better, you know. So the dream had a dream of its own that was bigger than mine. So we're back here, but it's all because of this stage right here. And I'm just never been more humbled in my life by this moment, honestly.
Yes, my name is Louis Chilko. I graduated in 1962. Right next to Lincoln was the old baseball park, Municipal Stadium, where the Kansas City Athletics, who are now the Oakland Athletics, played, and all the Hall of Fame professional baseball players played there. And we could run across the street and jump into the stadium, and I got to see those people in person, like Yogi Berra, Mickey Mantle, Al Kaline, etc. I have two daughters who are also graduates of Lincoln College Prep. My oldest daughter, Dr. Aisha Chilcote, graduated in the class of 1994 and then went from Lincoln to the Johns Hopkins University. My youngest daughter, Judge Jalila Chilcote Otto, is now Circuit Court Judge here in Kansas City, and she went to Tulane University in New Orleans, Louisiana. Well, Lincoln had that pride growing up as a youngster. All the adults that were educated, pretty much all graduates of Lincoln. Most of my teachers had graduated from Lincoln. So Lincoln was instilled in us from a very young age. Oh yes, the Lincoln Building was the pride of the Black community. It was known as the Castle on the Hill.
My name is Darren Story. I graduated from Lincoln in 1982. A friend of mine always tells me that some kind of way, I find a way to tell people I graduated from Lincoln in any conversation that I have. Well, my son is a junior here at Lincoln. He's way better than me because I was always in the band room when I probably should have been in class. If I'm to be honest, I got to Lincoln High School my freshman year was the year that we were desegregated. We became Lincoln Academy for Accelerated Study, and we were deemed a magnet school. But there was an energy in the school that it was palpable. It was. I'm here. I'm at Lincoln, and Lincoln, the place, the building symbolizes excellence, as far as I'm concerned. It signifies history. It signifies triumph. Remember, the list goes on and on and on of influential African Americans who walked these halls, and there was a standard that was set, and it was something that I think we all thought about when we all got here. You need to understand who's walked these halls, the time of history that these halls were being walked, the temperature and the climate of our city, of our nation during the time that Lincoln was taking shape, that this was the educational Taj Mahal for Black Kansas City in most of the decades that it's existed. You are now attending one of the greatest institutions, not in this city, but potentially in this country, and that you should feel privileged that you are able to go here. You should feel privileged that in the middle of this city sits this school on this hill that is giving you a world-class education.
Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring, ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies. Let it resound loud as the rolling sea. Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. Facing the rising sun of our new day begun, let us march on till victory is won.
Well, hello, my name's Erica. My rap name is Queenie. I'm a junior. The song that I made is called Easy. I made this song because I actually gave up on music like the end of my sophomore year, and I wasn't gonna do it no more. And it was a whole lot of. So actually this song just tells how my mom and them talked me out of giving up, so yeah.
They gon' make it happen. Go get the money, queen. Go get the money.
Easy.
Go get the money, queen. Go get the money.
They ready.
Go get the money, queen. Go get the money.
Let them know.
Go get the money, queen. Go get the money.
Queen of the streets, they bring the money to me. I need my money up front. I does nothing for free, they wanna be me, that's tough. Cause this ain't easy, and I'm bossy, of course. Cause I get what I please, number one baller on the court. I'm the MVP, I'm the queen of the streets. They bring the money to me, I need my money up front. I does nothing for free, they wanna be me, that's tough. Cause this ain't easy. easy, they said I couldn't, so I did it 10 toes standing. I'm grinding hard, I'm trying to get that gold and platinum. The crowd crazy, they love me, they jumping at me. I gave up, but my restart is automatic. I tell my haters sit down, they don't want no static. I've been fiending for the music just like kinetic. I'm going to the top floor, I ain't talking next. I'm coming for all the smoke, yeah, I'm problematic. I'm a die-co, greatest thing that ever happened. My foot on they throat, guaranteed I'ma have gag. Bossy, yes, I know, if I want it, I'ma make it happen. Bossy, yes, I know, if I want it, they gon' make it happen. Go get the money, queen, go get the money. Go get the money, queen, go get the money. Go get the money, queen, go get the money. Go get the money, queen, go get the money. I'm the queen of the streets, they bring the money to me. I need my money up front, I does nothing for free. They wanna be me, that's tough, cause this ain't easy. And I'm bossy, of course, cause I get what I please. Number one baller on the court, I'm the MVP. I'm the queen of the streets, they bring the money to me. I need my money up front, I does nothing for free. They wanna be me, that's tough, cause this ain't easy. Let them know.
This is an ode to my voice, a black woman's voice, but most importantly, black, and secondly, woman. And I know the conjunction of these words do scare people, and indeed you should be scared, because see, I was taught that my voice was a weapon before I was taught its power, that I resurrect revolutions from the realms of my lips, this voice be Oluwatoyin. 19 and 50 shades of activists gone too soon, my throat long like the spines of my ancestors. Always just around the corner from cracking, but it never does, because this throat like those bodies don't get the luxury of giving up. And need I remind you, it'd be the sweetest thing you have ever known, like Lauren. But it only takes 2 seconds for me to check you like Badu, and no, I am not sorry. Cause you niggas like to throw gasoline, knowing that this mouth spits fire, so don't be surprised when you get burnt. And even then, this tongue still finds ways out of no ways to nurse the bruises that you think I caused, to cradle your brokenness with zero thanks in return. So again, this is an ode to my voice, a black woman's voice, and round of applause to the ones that couldn't be silenced. And no, this ain't an oppression poem. This is a black voice, I hear you and I love you poem, a love letter to my vocal cords for piercing every eardrum unwilling to listen. My voice be the gunshot heard around the world, ain't no dodging this one. Take my words and call them siren. Even through all of the methods that are used to subdue me, these lips will still speak anointings onto the generations to come.
Brothers Black on black banders, I say it's champagne. I did the damn thing. Dirty Diana, singing and dancing all in the rain. Ooh, I just wanna have a good time. Turn around, kick them side. Twirl yourself to the right now. Ooh, bunny hop, drop, pop. Cross your legs, turn around and clap. Shuffle to the left, let's glide now. Ooh, drop it down, low, 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 low to the floor. Bring it up, Captain Roll. I say it's champagne. I did the damn thing. Dirty Diana, singing and dancing all in the rain. Ooh, I just wanna have a good time. Turn around, kick inside. Twirl yourself to the right now. Ooh, bunny hop, drop, pop. Cross your legs, turn around and clap. Shuffle to the left, let's glide now. Ooh, drop it down, low, 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 low to the floor. Bring it up, Captain Roll, roll. Step on them, step on them, step on them, step. Step on them, kick on them, stomp then you step. Swag the right. Surf to left, work the middle till it hurt a little. Before I let go. Dirty Diana, singing and dancing all in the rain. Turn around, kick them side. Twirl yourself to the right now. Ooh, bunny hop, drop, pop. Cross your legs, turn around and clap. Shuffle to the left, let's glide now. Ooh, drop it down, low, 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 low to the floor. Bring it up, Captain Roll, roll. Step on them, step on them, step on them, step. Step on them, kick on them, stomp then you step. Swag the right, surf the left. Work the middle till it hurt a little.